Hello everybody, it is me Magma, here with a LEGO Star Wars review. This time we got the Battle of Hoth at 75014. Sadly, this set is already retired, but it came out about a year and a half ago in the winter 2014. Actually, winter 2013. This is at 75014, ages 8 to 14, Battle of Hoth. To say overall what I think of this set quickly, this set is basically adding, you're like supposed to buy one or two of these to add towards your Hoth collection, because a wide speeder everyone kind of gets those. Kenan, this is kind of unique. This droid, we haven't gotten this for a while, but this cannon, you know, the style of these kind of like walls and stuff, Snowspeeder, all this is So if you haven't gotten one of these, here is your chance. Actually, it's already retired, but you can probably find this set around in some stores. So, yay. The Tauntaun. Yay, the Tauntaun. Everyone loves Tauntauns. So here what you want to do is, you know, all this is pretty straightforward. I shouldn't have to explain too much, because just if you look at my old videos, all of this, everything here is a double except for the big turret that I will show you. So yeah, you just put him on the Tauntaun and yeah, it's a Tauntaun. So yeah. That's cool. Next it is the this. It's like a so you know, it's like something the rebels built. So it's supposed to go kind of like this. And what you're meant to do is put your soldiers all around. So I'm gonna go ahead and explain you guys how this is all working out. So this gun is really, really cool. It turns 360. It goes up and down. It's like a mega machine gun. And you can put a guy behind there so that he can, a trooper, so that he can, you know, stand here with the gun like this. He can go around and shoot all those snowtroopers. So that is an awesome design of a gun for Hoth, and definitely this is a really, really cool design. I would actually want to chop this off the platform and actually use it in so many things and so many opportunities. So that's really cool. Then in the middle you have this like hole, so it's kind of like the place where all the troopers leave their little fortress and go forward. Shovel and a pickaxe, because obviously they had to, you know, dig to make this, these like snow walls, like we could say. A little radar here and a box container. As always, Lego decides to be weird and they added a wiener in the container. Little sausage thing. I mean, this is really useless, kind of weird. I mean, you could say it's food for the soldiers, but yay. So yeah, that's that, guys. It's kind of awkward, weird, but yeah, at least you got a wiener. So that is the little fortress. I don't know how to say this. Next is like the command center and the gun. So that's the only thing I haven't gotten before, and the reason why I actually got this set is to get these parts to build this cannon. So yeah, it's, you guys may know a bit about this, but yeah. Okay, so can that guy please shut up? I'm gonna actually close the door. There we go. Okay, so here is a look at the command center, kind of. So you got a little place to keep this. Actually, a little command center. So what you want to do here is take his gun, put his gun on that, and add your general here so that he can work outside in the fresh air with all those lasers. Yeah. Okay. Here we got a container, empty obviously, but has a cup on it for some reason. And this is empty down here, so we can hide some stuff. And up here it's like a little turret. So you can flick the missile, but it's not supposed to be a missile, it's like, it's supposed to be the place where the laser comes out of, But LEGO decided to make it as well a missile. So, yeah. Supposedly, the laser comes out of this, but it's a missile. And it turns almost 360. The problem for the 360 is his head. Yay. And this box. So here on the back, you got your flick, fire missile, and you got this. So what you want to do here is, this is supposed to be like the binoculars, so that the trooper, who we have here, actually I'm going to take one back there, you want to have your trooper, and he can look into this, and kind of like, you know, use these handles, and this is the binoculars to actually watch where he's shooting, and he can shoot those AT-ATs. So I really, really like that. It's really, really creative, interesting, and it's very Star Wars looking. So yeah, so that's definitely a reason why you should get this set, is all those pieces that assemble up a little command center. Definitely something I have been looking to get lately. So, on to the Snowspeeder. Well, this is like any other Snowspeeder, pretty basic. I'm gonna give you guys a look around of the Snowspeeder. The engine does not remove like the 2007 version. So yeah, you go down here, harpoon gun. Obviously this can be released, and I don't think that it is long enough to get around the AT-AT. And this can open like this or like this. So here you got a little, the harpoon screen has those AT-AT walker legs. Here's the place for a second pilot, and here's the place for Luke. Obviously tell that AT-AT sticker on the screen. Luke has to get rid of his lightsaber. I don't know where you put it. Probably in the back seat. And you want to add Luke here. So yeah, Luke can be piloting. And we can close down on him. So that's the Snowspeeder, really. It's pretty basic, just like the other ones. I find it a bit tiny, probably a stud, smaller than my 2007 version. So you're definitely, obviously, getting a comparison for that, for the Snowspeeder. My comparison series will be continuing once I get over all of these reviews done. Here is the sticker sheet. So yeah, quite a few stickers. You do get two small instruction manuals. That was pretty surprising.